BSc Honoris Causa to Sri Mukesh Ambani.
A warm good evening to each and every one of you. For me, being at UDCT is always a pleasant experience. I first came here in 1975, and this institute is what I consider home, my own, and what made me. Over the years, I have had the good fortune of many recognitions, many awards, but this evening and today is special. It is special when somebody your own, somebody you consider your own, an institute where you've spent the best years of our life, chooses to recognize you, and I am, from the bottom of my heart, grateful to the Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, and the Board of Governors of ICT. Deeply grateful, sir. It's an even special, bigger honor to receive it after Professor C.N.R. Rao, Professor M.M. Sharma, and George Watsides, who is an institution in himself. And I don't think that I actually deserve to stand among these four great people. At the forefront of academic excellence over eight decades. When I came here in 1975, this was the best institute in the 70s. And believe me, like all of you, 1974 Interscience was still the hardest that I ever worked in my life because I wanted to get into UDCT. And since then, over decades, whether it was Professor Daruwala, after that Professor Sharma, Professor J.B. Joshi, and now our very popular Professor G.D. Yadav, ICT has only gone higher and higher. And for me to really accept and be honored in terms of not only my guru, but I think now he is Jag Guru, Professor Sharma, is a very, very special honor. And he being present with all of you is really wonderful for me and very memorable. If I really look at my 35 or 36 years, India in the 80s was still called an emerging or a developing economy. Many people called us third world countries. As a young chemical engineer, I remember in the early 80s going to Dr. Vijay Kelkar's office, and he was then chairman of BICP, and he said, you know, will we in India ever beat the Koreans and the Taiwanese in making polyester? And will we ever be competitive? Today, after 35 years, Reliance is the largest polyester manufacturer in the world. And undoubtedly, like ICT has proven, that in academic excellence, we can sustain over eight decades. The young people of India have proven that we can take any sector and build world-class companies and really compete with the world on our own merits. For me, the 35-year-old journey has been very special. We have invested and I have had the good fortune of participating hands-on in investments of over 300,000 crores of building grassroots assets in India. And it gives me great satisfaction that most of our major decisions were taken either in consultation with Professor Sharma, or sometimes we've already stood in his room and we have lots of our people working with him. So UDCT, ICT now, has a great role in building the Reliance of today. As we, to all my young friends and some of the older PhD students, I would second what George said, that this is really one of the most interesting times for technologists, chemical technologists, and people with a flair for science and technology. Over the next two decades, as all of you now leave your academic portals and enter the real life, this is going to be one of the most exciting times for you to solve practical real world problems and improve quality of life of tens of millions of people. My warm congratulations to each and every one of you for graduating today. You are graduating from the finest technological institute in India. India has great expectations out of each and every one of you. And I can foresee a day where many of you will not take 36 years like me to receive recognition from your alma mater, but will do it in 15 or 20 years. And I can see that some of you would contribute to really break through technology initiatives that change not only India, but the world. All the very best and good luck to you. Finally, I accept this recognition very humbly. In remembrance of one person who has had deep impact on my life, and that is my father, Dhirubhai Ambani. He has demonstrated that even in India, we can start a company with 1,000 rupees and make it among the top 100 companies in the world. And he has taught me, which I want to share with all the students, that always think bold and think in an expansive, big way. Do not have any inferiority complex. He has taught me to always be an optimist. Think about the positive aspects of life. Keep positive in life, no matter what difficulty. He has taught me always embrace technology, embrace excellence, try to be the best, not the best in India, not the best in your region, but the best in the world. And then you will solve real life problems and create assets that the world and India will be proud of. And I'm sure that all of you will do that. With that, I really thank all of you and dedicate this recognition really to the over 100,000 people of Reliance who have made Reliance what it is today. Thank you.